Good morning, students. In our previous video on report writing, we discussed about newspaper reports, particularly report about accidents and natural disasters. Today, we will discuss about another newspaper report, that is crime report. By the end of this video, you will be able to understand what are crime reports, how to write crime reports, and important vocabulary related to crime reports. Now let us discuss the format of a crime report. The crime report will have a heading in the center of the page. Then you will introduce it with the byline, that is the name of the reporter. Then you will write down the name of a place of occurrence and also the date of occurrence, that is your dateline. In the body of the crime report, you will write down what happened, when did it happen, where did it happen, how did it happen, and who all were involved in it. You may also take other details such as action taken, and you may conclude it with the eyewitness accounts and the comments of the authority. So children, as we know that crime reports are written in third person passive voice. Only the account of eyewitness can be in the first person active voice, and this should be kept within inverted commas. So let us see the outline of this report. Theft in a jeweler's house, modus operandi, damage and losses, eyewitness account, neighbors' reactions, and official action. Now see the term modus operandi, children. This term modus operandi is used in police work while discussing crime and addressing the methods employed by the criminals. So let us start with the crime report. This is the heading of the report. Valuable cash looted from jeweler's house. So it will be in the center of the page. In byline, you will write down the name of the reporter, by Gurmeet Singh. In dateline, you will write down the name of the place and date. Ludhiana, September 17. Thieves decamped. Decamped, children, means ran away. So thieves decamped with jewelry, valuables and cash worth over rupees 5 lakh from the residence of a jeweler in Sector 40 under Civil Lines Police Station area in Ludhiana. The family was away in a Delhi hospital where a relative was admitted. Now see your outline, children. This first paragraph tells us the first point, that is theft in a jeweler's house. Jeweler B.C. Sood, who lives in house number 163 of C block of Sector 40, owns a reputed jewelry store, Hans Jewelers, in the old city. See the word reputed, children. Reputed means well known. He was shocked to find his house ransacked when he returned home after 2 days. So what is the meaning of ransacked, children? Ransacked means when the things are stolen and damage is caused. All the Elmira locks were broken and goods strewn. What is the meaning of strewn? It means untidily scattered. So this tells us about his condition after the theft had taken place, right? The grill of the kitchen window was missing. Presumably, that was the mode of entry and exit. So the kitchen window grill was missing, and it is thought that the thieves entered through this window and went away through this window. This is also our modus operandi, children. I told you what is modus operandi. Modus operandi is the methods employed by the criminal, right? So this line tells us about the modus operandi. The robbers had helped themselves with gold worth rupees 2 lakh, rupees 50,000 in cash, costly electronic gadgets and some artifacts. See the word artifacts, children. Artifact means ornaments or other historical goods. Even some expensive garments and upholstery is missing. What is the meaning of upholstery, children? Upholstery means soft covering on chairs or sofas to make them comfortable. Now, from the robbers till missing, this paragraph tells us about the next point, that is damage and losses. According to the residents, over 50 thefts have taken place in this area in the last 5 months, but the police have failed to solve most of the cases so far. So this tells us about the neighbors' reaction and also tells us about the inability of the police. S.K. Sahni, the spokesperson of Residents Welfare Association, who lives in the adjacent house, was the one who informed the police and the Sood family. He said, now children, just see this line. This is an eyewitness account, so has to be kept in inverted commas, and also it will be written in first person active voice. So he said, I saw 4 men in a car in front of the house at midnight. When I called out to them from my balcony, they looked alarmed and fled. What is the meaning of alarmed, children? Alarmed means frightened, and they fled. Here we are closing the inverted commas. That means the eyewitness account has been over. However, due to darkness, he couldn't see their faces and the car clearly, he added. So this paragraph, children, covers neighbors' reactions. The police have, however, nabbed 2 of the bandits. What is the meaning of nabbed, children? Nabbed means grabbed. 2 of the bandits. Who are bandits? Bandits are robbers who had looted a Santro car last week, while 2 other thieves had slipped from the police dragnet. And see the word dragnet, children? It means a systematic search for some criminal. So the police have, however, nabbed 2 of the bandits who have looted a Santro car last week, while 2 other thieves had slipped from the police dragnet. 4 bandits in a Wagonar had looted a Santro car from the golf course roundabout on August 4, when Santro driver Joginder had been threatened at gunpoint by the thieves. The culprits are suspected to have some connection with this incident as well. So what is this para suggesting, children? This tells us about the official action. That means the action taken by the police. Let us discuss about some of the important vocabulary which is used in crime reports. What is the meaning of decamp, children? It means running away. Ransacked, when things are stolen and are badly destroyed. Goods strewn, when the goods are scattered untidily. And nab the culprits, when the police catch hold of the culprits. Now see your homework, children. Using the notes given below, you are to write a report on the following incident under the title Bank Robbery Foiled. So you can see that the title, that is the heading, has already been given, Bank Robbery Foiled. Now remember, children, this is not an essay, but it is a report. So you are to give factual details. That means you are to give the details based on the facts. So let us see the hints. A quiet morning at the bank, few customers, 3 suspicious looking persons carrying briefcases, walk towards counters, point guns at the customers and bank employees, cashier's hand in money, quick action of policemen, press guns on the backs of the robbers, robbers surrender and let into a policeman, bank employees and customers relieved. You may include other relevant details.